So, goblin scouts are missing and we need to hunt them down. Check out this rock over there. They carved a small tunnel to the other side. It seems not very stable. Don't forget taking some light with you. It's dark on the other side. I got a torch. Something. Passage is blocked. I will have to find another way back to the camp. Firebug lair. It should not be necessary. Drow and elves in general should have dark. No one uses light here, down the dark. Fuck. Blind and deaf. I don't really dare to move up. No, I don't think it's an actual trap. I think as long as we're moving in here, it's fog that's gonna happen.
To the front! Give new quarter!
Captain Ilmarin's corpse. Guess we found out what happened to the drow. Vampiric rapier. Medium arm. Fire beetle belly. Not really interested in that. Okay, now there's water here. Probably under some lake. Crystal room. Probably where we need to go. However, I'd like to see if we can find out some more about the missing people. Back. Why am I killing bats? Yeah. Don't really see why I even have to fight these bats. But as long as they're hostile, I sort of do. If for nothing else, for the simple reason, it'll confuse the AI. It's better to clear them all out. Ooh, someone's using a light there. Lizardmen. They're decent. There's nothing particularly weak about them.
There is nothing for you here!
Time to die!
Okay, this is a bit dangerous. There's a shaman there. Jesus Christ. Yeah, critical hit. Didn't exactly do a lot of damage. I think they all made their saving throws. No, just did shit damage. XP loss for a henchman. Lost henchman. But that's annoying. Ah. Not noticed that.
Back with you!
Seems to have recovered on its own. You get that. We've got this.
Well met. Hello.
General update. Let's see a journal update. So we need to be a bit careful. They're definitely throwing a lot of magical items around in this campaign. How the hell am I gonna get that? Oh, that's why we have this. We need to be able to do elemental damage, probably. No way we can do it. I might have a buff spell to do it. What was it? Darkfire. Bill allows the caster to emulate an unmagical weapon. Critical hit costs damage.
To the fight! Let it be.
No, do we have... No, just let it be. You have to be a bit careful about losing companions then. It's nice that they get automatically a recover, but an experience points lost, so... That can be fairly annoying. We can't constantly keep losing them, otherwise we're not going to make much of a progress. Where's Mahalur potions? Good chance we get a replacement armor out of this. I've played Marine Leaf. Drow chain shirt. It's probably the best one. Amulet of Will. Okay. We're going to have to buff ourselves. We want to
do this.
We want to have any hope of pushing through here.
Okay. I'm done with this.
Excellent. Money. And decent equipment upgrades. Probably a wand of magic missiles. Still lacking in strength. Not sure what to do. Can't exactly abandon the equipment. Money is too important. I can't give him the equipment. So... not much we can do. Ah, thank goodness. I don't think we've been here yet. Looks like a dead end, but is it? Yes. Okay, so now what? Crystal room. There's a man inside a crystal there. A lizard man. Go. Old battles. Okay, just a large group of skeletons, I suppose. That's really it. Pretty much. Well, if you want any kind of bone ingredient, this is certainly the best place to visit. The large bones are for bone wands. What is this? Some kind of tunnel that goes lower. What's the other path? Serious crypt. Cloth. A red dragon. Yeah, we're certainly not picking a fight with him, but...
Kneel before me, mortal, for I am a cloth, ancient worm of the north.
I am unworthy, mighty cloth. I didn't mean to disrupt your lair.
You are right. Leave before I decide to feast upon your bones.
Please have mercy with me, O mighty dragon. I am on my way. I swear I won't disturb you anymore. This seems a bit suspicious. Why are there so many locations here if I can't do anything with the bastard?
You have my attention for the moment.
May I ask you a few questions?
You dare approach me with questions?
I'm sorry, Cloth, but yes.
Such an insult. Cover before me and beg for pardon, or I may roast you with one mighty blow.
Didn't you get killed in your lair by some adventurers from Neverwinter? I'm not sure where this is going, because naturally I would know nothing about this.
Killed? Me? No. Do I look dead?
What the fuck? It's hard to say, someone likes ellipses.
Do I look like I am dead? It's just rumors, yes. It's just rumors. They're not true.
So you solved that little problem with your aging too?
My aging? What aging? Ah, yes, that, sure. I took some precautions and now I'm young and strong again.
But you are an ancient dragon, not a young dragon.
Ah, damn, cleric. You won't let me fool you, will you? So be it. Feel my wrath.
What is it, really? It's not a dragon, clearly. Still hit me once with his dragon ability, so that's bullshit.
To the fight! Give no quarter!
Ooh, blind misdeafness might work well on that one. It had a decent chance to work, it didn't work. No, we need to attack. Kill it before it gets needing a... Mage just tried to fool us. I don't mind that you can question him and be able to disrupt that, but it's odd just in how we managed to do that. We should not have... I have no reason to believe why we should have known anything of the events from Neverwinter Nights 1. Again, using the equipment. And we got a cloak! Yay for a cloak! Our big ass is sort of showing through the cloak, but whatever. Warrior summoning bow. Summoning bowls were originally designed for purposes of creating a large number of undead. This special bow may summon a powerful undead warrior to accompany you. The creature may fight your enemies and guard you, but it may not take orders from you. This service has no time limit. The undead creature is bound to your service until you release it or it is destroyed. The summoning process will render the bow useless. Nonetheless, forcing the dead into your service is evil, and so using this bow will turn your personality slowly to the evil side. Your minion will suffer great pains while summoned, and so he will beg you to release him. Refusing this means trapping him into your service, but also means turning your alignment more and more to evil. So that's not a problem. Not a problem at all. It has a single use. not sure at what point we should use this. Because I'm not quite sure how it works. It says it has no time limit, but we're switching modules and things like that. So I doubt it'll stick with us. There is a box with a white powder at the top of the pool. Water inside the pool shows the picture of a red dragon in a crypt. Pour some powder. Scenario changes. The water shows the picture of a group of drow. Can I touch it? Well, fuck me. We're certainly not gonna survive this. Your life.
Die, unworthy foe.
I'm gonna load, but let's see what else can we do with this. Dragon crypts. So you can teleport into where it shows, but what is that? Red egg then. Good luck trying to loot any of this. That's an actual dragon. So this would be a good way to make some cash. But. And there's that but. Way too much equipment. Yeah, going into the dragon's lair probably would earn us something, but I'm not sure what would be a good way to even try to do it. Invisibility, I don't know if it would make much of a difference. It's a dragon, it's gonna see us. We are gonna need more strength no matter what. Yes, charge him. And dragon fear. What I really just wanted to know is the egg there something we can interact with, or is it just for show?
Well met. Hello.
True seeing. Don't think invisibility is gonna help here. Yeah, I'm just not gonna do this. We're going to get the saving throw at one point, but it's just not worth it.
Fall in step as you should! Follow!
Gonna spend a little bit of time buffing himself up. So we're gonna use that time to loot what we can and get the fuck out. Yep, now's to get the fuck out time. Too late.
Step as you should. Hollow.
Treasure. There's only two piles here that have any significant amount of loot. So I think I'll just take them and run. Hello, Mr. Goblin. Very likely going to be a fight here. Still, I don't see any casters, just archers and a captain.
At last, Dark Ones found us.
You don't seem surprised. What do you expect me to do now?
Dark Ones, right. The expected hunters or goblins are prepared to defend.
You think I've come to kill you?
So, way of the Dark Ones is. You talk long for killing us.
You are right. Let's come to an end. Your end. Come on, take the captain down. It's fairly good, though. Yeah, interruptions. Fuck! That didn't take long. And you're doing nothing again! Jesus fucking Christ. Not too worried about these guys. But what a catastrophe again. Losing the... Why is he hostile? Yeah, this didn't go well. More importantly, why is he hostile? Yeah. Not acceptable. Definitely going to die, that won't change. What I'm really wondering is why. Sakes, take him down. Trying to keep him alive.
No quarter!
And we are failing terribly. Hits, trying not to die.
There is nothing for you here.
That critical hit came right at the perfect time. Any loots? No. No lootsies. Might as well move closer to the exit. Yeah, we have so much crap we're carrying. I need to get to a shop as soon as possible. And didn't really use my potions again. The river is calm and shallow here. Maybe I can swim back to the camp. Yeah. Maybe.
Well met.
So four cleric levels. Should we craft wands? Costs a lot of money and experience points. It's just certain, like a wand that has the disarm traps would be great, because even though we have it as a spell, it's not really that good. First of all, we don't have that many spell slots, and we don't really want to spend spell slots on it anyway. But more to the point, if it's in a wand, it's always available when we need it, and there's probably enough charges that even a single wand can possibly be good enough to last throughout the entire game. It costs a lot of money, and I'm not sure if feat is worth taking for a single ability. Might be pretty much better with anything else. I know what I'm gonna take. We have extend spell. Doubles the spell slot. No. Expend spell occupies a spell slot one high level higher than normal. Basically doubles the duration. Yep. It's much more important. Reason why it's important is, for example, divine power, good ability, but duration sucks. If it's two rounds per level instead of one, we're starting to look at a ability that will probably last through a fight. So it makes it a lot more attractive of an ability. Mingle. Another second level ability. We're not going to take the maybe webbing. Web is another spell that is it's actually quite nice. However, it's not something I'd like to carry with me constantly. Maybe more dexterity or constitution. Old person, very useful though. Would have saved our lives a couple of times if we had an extra one. So, or rather, his life. We haven't talked to him. Maybe we should. Animate dead. That's a good summon. Not that powerful. But stone bones. Cause the target undead to gain +3 to natural armor class bonus. So we could basically buff our own undead. Like that. Interesting for another reason. Dark fire will probably work with it. Not sure how attached I want to be to this guy. He is very useful, but at the same time, sort of a pain in the ass.
Well met. Hello.
You said you were with Major Beandre at Mithril Hall. Tell me more about this disaster. I can only add to those stories everyone knows. We fought an army of dwarves, gnomes, and humans there. It was horrible. I was lucky to be with the group which attacked the lower tunnels. Others had to enter the surface. They were never seen again.
Tell me more about the fights against those dwarves, gnomes, and humans.
I, for my part, only encountered dwarves. They began as hell with their tough as hell with their thick, hard armor and rough constitution. I saw dwarves hit by 20 or more drow balls, still fighting as if they were unharmed.
What do you know about humans and gnomes?
I've told you enough about Mithril Hall. Let's change the topic.
Tell me more about yourself, Kaluith.
There's nothing much to tell. I'm a mercenary selling my sword to the best payroll.
Mistress Beweewin is paying fairly well, and so I joined her group. Don't let us talk so much. Let's do our job and capture those goblin slaves.
Well met. Hello.
What options do we have? Use ranged weapons. Don't help if we fail to open doors. So our options with this guy are fairly limited. I do want to get rid of the extra equipment we have. Give us a decent amount of cash. See if there's anything new we can buy. You return! How unexpected! Come over here, I want to have some word with you.
Yes!
Die, unworthy foe!
Okay. You want to talk with me, but not really.
Yes!
I think I screwed things up by trying to talk to him. Yeah, they're gnomes. Ones who were mining. They summon earth elementals. Weapon ineffective. That's nice. Might be able to confuse it a little bit. No immunity to mind spells. I don't think it works. So they fireballed him. Not my fault.
Taste the pain.
Attack glass. Get on with it.
Their attack has been put down, but we stand to lose much if such skirmishes continue. They are resilient. Dare I ask how many we face? Do not worry, they are nothing we cannot handle. Now, you mentioned that you had found an old battle site to the north, yes? Yes, it is situated at the river's edge with a strange red light cast over it. There is a clear trail leading upward, but I do not know where it leads. You have served my purposes well. Finally, Chalash Mortar is ours. Incline head respectfully. Now, did you kill those goblin scouts? Yes, I killed them all. Good. Then I have another task for your seemingly capable hands. Speak it, and it shall be done. While you were exploring the northern caves, a sprinkling force broke through the western caves. As for how they knew of us, that is a mystery. That weakling Commander Risen was overrun. Our forces have regrouped here. I always thought Swiftnibbling to be inconsequential little fodder, but their minion was anything but. They are led by a powerful cleric. He surely summoned the Earth Elemental to throw against us. Dealing with them is no simple matter. What would you have me do then? You will make your way through the western tunnels and kill this meddlesome cleric. You must do this on your own. I can spare no single drow to aid you in this. You are our diversion while we regroup at the river. Mistress, do not question my orders. Avoid enemy forces, hide or set trap for them as needed. Do what you must, but go and kill this cleric. Meet us at the lakeside when you have accomplished your mission. As you wish. Mistress Pwiwin walks away before you have a chance to finish. Yeah, she doesn't give a shit.
Is this my old friend Belaya?
Old friend, perhaps for the time being.
So, you have been ordered to kill this Swiftnibbling cleric. What will you do? Die, perhaps? For all intents and purposes, your task sounds like suicide.
Do you have any advice for me?
If you're willing to listen, I may be able to offer some advice.
Pre-advice? I find that unlikely.
Your success is my payment. Those gnomes are threatening all of us.
Fine then, tell me what you know.
Swiftnibbling, or deep gnomes as they are also known, possess incredible cunning and intelligence. They live in elaborate cities such as we do, and the nearest such city is Blingdenstone.
How have they gotten here?
Blingdenstone is a constant thorn in our side. I had the unfortunate pleasure of taking part in the disastrous attack against Mithril Hall years ago. The gnomes joined the dwarves that day. Since that time, they've been increasingly more active against us.
But why are they here? We are many miles from any drow settlement.
They may have been scrying this area, as there is an opening to the upper region of the night below around these parts.
Yes, there is. I saw it for myself while I was searching for the renegade goblins.
So you see the truth in my words?
And what can I possibly do about these earth elementals the gnomes summon?
Swiftnibbling have a natural affinity with the earth, making it far easier for them to summon the elementals from the very rock around us. Though resilient, they can be destroyed.
Destroyed? Did you not witness the ordeal I had to go through just to scratch it?
Only the finest adamantine or potent magical weapons can harm them.
And if I have none?
So, buy one. Okay. Adamantine dagger. Earth hammer. Yeah, we can use the dagger and that's it. I want to see if I can level up first. Because if we get a feat, things might change for us. Yeah. Martial weaponry. Oh, we can take exotic weaponry. Bastard sword, dire mace, dwarven war axe, double axe, kama, katana, kukri, sky, shuriken, whip, two blade shot, martial weaponry, thanks. Zen archery would be good to use wisdom score to use ranged weapons instead of dexterity. But I'd like to expand our selection of weapons we can use.
Yes! 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 Yes, 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 yes. Yes.
This is oddly implemented. Why can't I just use the shop another time? We'll have to redo the fucking fight. And I'm not pleased at all. That's badly implemented. I just don't see why you would limit the use of the shop to one. Doesn't make any sense to me. Maybe it would have been more effort and didn't see any need for it. Because the store opens automatically. I don't know.
Taste the pain!
Taste the mob. Not much we can do about it.
Fall in step as you should. Hollow.
I can do this.
I'm not gonna risk myself. Really, really, no need to do that. I don't really have a weapon that would affect them anyway. I do need to see it through though. Because I need to level up. Doesn't matter if we can level up before the Triandir comes to talk to us. Because now I know I can get the necessary weapon skills to get the weapons. It was one of the things I thought about taking right at the start, so it's not like.
Fall in step as you should! Hollow! Fall in step as you should!
I can do this.
Hollow!
Let them do the dying.
Gorak, boom, okay.
Do the fight!
If you fought us!
Your life.
Get on with it.
Get a level up this time. And why did I get the level up last time then? Light hammer. Damage bonus versus elementals. Yeah. Attack bonus versus elementals. Adamantine weapons on the other hand. Plus 2. So basically buy a plus 2 weapon or earth hammer. I guess we're gonna take the normal dagger. I don't see much of a choice. Okay, what else can we... Stolen goods? Bullshit. Castando staff. Bad. Holy shit, boots of elven kind. Very useful. Is that it? And we can move again. Vampiric rape here. Not bad, but still no. Don't have any interest in any rapiers. There might have been an alternative way to do things. Now that I think about it. We do have a spell that allows us to create a magical weapon. So maybe we could have used that to get the necessary bonuses to attack or do or damage them. No, it's Chris plus one in enchantment bonus, not good enough. So, never mind. Dark Pyre will work on them. Oh shit, just don't see how this is gonna go well for us. I suppose we can create a powerful undead creature, so maybe we can use that to fight them off. Especially if we buff it, but not exactly a great situation for us.
Yes.
Yes. Well, the situations were far from perfect, but I guess our sidekick is coming along. Okay. That'll make things a lot easier for us. So this shouldn't be that bad then. Not saying it's easy taking on another Earth Elemental on our own. But it's not going to go down well. I don't think I want to carry this extra loot. Might be worth something at a later point in time, but we're getting fairly well equipped by just basically doing nothing. We'll have to do so.
go this sort of nippling breakthrough and try to kill the Earth Elemental. No, try to kill the cleric who's responsible for the Earth Elementals. If there's one thing you can take from this is that we're basically treated as fodder. It is sacrificial pawn. So the leadership can escape while we get to sacrifice ourselves. It's pretty clear that they don't expect me to come back. Just delay until they can move away from here. I'm just saying, if there becomes a situation where we can, for our own benefit, screw them over, yeah, we have very, very, very little reason not to do it.